Hello everyone, welcome again to another session of Minds Group Tech. Today we are continuing on our topic related to AngularJS with ASP.NET MVC. In this video, we are going to continue on building an ASP.NET MVC application from scratch. I'm assuming that you are already aware of ASP.NET MVC and you know how to create an MVC application. I will be deviating a little bit here and there while creating MVC application in Visual Studio. So I will recommend you to watch closely. So let's continue. Open our Visual Studio. Let's go and create a new project. Control Shift N. I'm selecting Visual C Sharp, web application, template, giving the project a name. Tutorial G1, click OK. Selecting empty template as compared to MVC over here and using add folders and core references for MVC. Click OK. Our project will be ready in a few seconds. Project structure is displayed over here. As you can see, it is empty. There is no controller, no scripts, nothing. So we have to go and create a new controller. Selecting MVC5 empty controller. Name it as home. Click add. Our controller is created. We have to right click on this, add a new view, use partial view, click OK. Enter your default favorite message, leave it here. Now, if you can see, we have a few scripts and style sheets added. So go ahead and remove them because we will be using Bower to install our dependencies. Manage NuGet packages. Select Bootstrap. Uninstall. Okay. Select jQuery. Click Uninstall. Okay. And at the end, Modernizer. Uninstall. Okay. While we are here, we need another package which we need to install from NuGet, that is Microsoft ASP.NET Web Optimization. This package will be required for minimizing and reducing the size of our scripts and style sheets. So let's go and install that. It may take a few seconds. Click OK. Accept the agreement. And it is done. Let's close NuGet Packet Manager. Right click on Start and create a new class. Name the class as bundle config.cs. Now we have to include certain things over here. Before that, we have to add our dependencies from Bower. So let's open command line PowerShell. Bower install bootstrap, click enter. And we have installed bootstrap along with jQuery, as jQuery is the required dependencies for bootstrap. Let's close this. in our bundle config, we have to create two bundles. I will copy and paste the code from my blog. So here we have created two bundles. One is for JavaScript and another is for styles. So let's include the required dependencies in this class. Let's go to our global asx.cs and register this bundle. Bundle config dot, first of all, take reference of this file, then register bundles. Now we need bundle table dot bundles, include the required references. Try building it, it should build. Yes, now go to our layout, replace this layout with this template. And now we have to include the required bundles. So in the header, we will include CSS, and in the footer, we will be including JavaScript. Now we have to include the references for scripts and styles. So let's open web config and include optimization. Build the project. If we reopen our layout, we can see the styles and scripts are properly referenced. The next thing, we have to include a navigation bar at the top. I'm copying it from my blog again, pasting it here. At this point, we require three additional views, page 1, page 2, and page 3 for this navigation. So let's go back to our controller and let's add three new views, page 1, page 2, page 3, right click on them and add view. Page 1 created, and give some text. Page 2 create, page 2 and page 3 add page 3. To demonstrate our optimization, we will go to our web config and make debugging false and try to run this application. Run without debugging. Open browser's developer console. Here we can see the JavaScript and CSS bundle are included over here, which are minimized. Here is our output. You can see the reference to our scripts over here and the styles over here. And our MVC application is ready for our next video, where we will be including AngularJS on top of it. If you like this video and would like to continue on this session, I will recommend you to subscribe to this channel so that you get a notification when the next video on this topic is published. Till then, have a nice day and thank you for watching.